Welcome to the Daily Reminder Network. Heart Softeners by Sheikh Mu'izz Bukhari.
My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters, and the viewers of the Daily Reminder Network, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa usalli wa usallimu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursaleen, Nabiyyina wa habibina wa qurrati a'yunina Muhammad ibn Abdullah, alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi afdalu salati wa atamu taslim amma ba'd. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector, and curer. We ask Allah the Almighty to shower His choicest of blessings and salutations upon our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. Insha'Allah ta'ala, for tonight's heart softener, we will be touching on a very great heart softener indeed. A heart softener that many of us, illa man rahim Allah, have begun to slacken in regard to. And that heart softener is dhikr, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the Almighty, He states in the Noble Quran,
أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ.
That unquestionably, hearts find rest, hearts find peace by the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once was with the Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, and he asks the Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, should I not inform y'all of the best of deeds? Ala ukhbirukum bi khayri a'malikum. Should I not inform y'all of the best of deeds? And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went on to ask them, and the narration goes along the lines of these words, should I not inform y'all of a deed that is even better than fighting in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Should I not inform you all of a deed that is better than dishing out charity, than giving out, than even spending gold and silver, Allahu Akbar, than even spending out big sadaqah? Shall I inform you all of such a deed? The Sahaba ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhi majma'in, they were very eager to know what this special deed is, and they asked, Ya Rasulullah, of course, do tell us what is this deed. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informs them, it is dhikrullah. It is the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states in the Noble Quran,
وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا.
The ones who make excessive dhikr, excessive remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the males and the females, Allahu Akbar,
أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for them maghfirah, forgiveness, وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا, and a great reward. Allahu Akbar. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, you look around you, the ants that crawl on the earth, they glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The birds that fly in the air, they glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The animals around us, they glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The creations around us, they praise and they glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah the Almighty states again in the Noble Quran,
وَإِمْ مِن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِن لَّا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ حَلِيمًا غَفُورًا.
وَإِمْ مِن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ. There is not a thing except that it glorifies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ. But you all do not understand its tasbih, the tasbih of the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, innahu kana haliman ghafura. Indeed, Allah the Almighty is most forbearing and the most forgiving. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have compared a living person with a dead person when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave the difference between a person who makes dhikr and a person who does not make dhikr. A person who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like a living person, Allahu Akbar. And the person who does not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like the dead. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. And may Allah the Almighty open the doors of goodness for us. Shaykhul Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he is reported to have said that dhikr is important to a believer. Dhikr, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is so important to a believer just as how water is important for a fish. Allahu Akbar. Can a fish survive outside water? Likewise, a believer cannot survive without the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Talking about fish and water, look at the story of Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. Allahu Akbar. We know that he left his nation. He left his nation because he was angry with them. He undertakes a sea journey, and what happens? The ship capsizes, he falls into the ocean, and a huge fish gobbles him up. Allahu Akbar. A huge fish swallows him up, and he is in the stomach, in the belly of that fish, and then he cries out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He makes remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He feels remorse and he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illa ant, la ilaha illa ant, subhanak, subhanak inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illa ant. There is no deity worthy of worship other than you, Ya Allah. Subhanak, glory be unto you. Inni kuntu min al-zalimin. I am indeed of the oppressors. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings out Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam from that fish. Allah the Almighty rescues him from that fish. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states in the noble Quran, فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. That if Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam was not from those who glorified Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he would have remained in the belly of that fish until the day of Qiyamah. Allahu Akbar. It was because of the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah the Almighty brought him out of that difficulty, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, and the narration goes along the lines of these words, the one who makes the dhikr, La ilaha illallah wahda, la sharika lah, lahul mulku wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Once again, let me repeat. La ilaha illallah wahda, la sharika lah, lahul mulku wa lahul hamd, wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. The one who makes this great dhikr 100 times a day, hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim. The one who makes the dhikr 100 times a day, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, how long is it going to take us to just sit and remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remember him and make the dhikr 100 times? If we were to do it 100 times, you know how great the rewards are? Allahu Akbar. There is a beautiful list. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went on to say, the rewards start off, number one, he gets the reward of emancipating 10 slaves. He gets the reward of freeing 10 slaves. Allahu Akbar. Number two, 100 good deeds are written in his register. 100 good deeds are written down for him. 100 evil deeds, 100 sins are erased from his register. Allahu Akbar. 100 good deeds are credited to your account, and 100 sins are deleted from your account. Allahu Akbar. And number four, he is saved from the devil, he is protected from the devil until evening falls. Say, if you make the dhikr in the morning, you are protected from the clutches of the devil or the traps of the devil until evening. If you make it in the evening, you are protected until the morning. Allahu Akbar. And the final reward, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, is that no one will be able to surpass him in reward in terms of that particular dhikr, and except for the one who makes excessive dhikr than him. Say, if a person were to make 200 times, that's the only way he would be able to surpass that particular individual. Allahu Akbar. A powerful dhikr indeed. Just a few minutes, if we could devote it to remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look at the rewards that Allah the Almighty is going to bestow upon us. The same hadith or the next hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes on to say, the individual who makes the dhikr of subhanallahi wa bihamdih, subhanallahi wa bihamdih, glory be unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and all praises belong to him. Subhanallahi wa bihamdih, 100 times. If an individual were to do it 100 times, all of his sins, minor sins, all of his minor sins, even if it be like the froth of the sea, Allahu Akbar, even if it be like the froth of the ocean, it will be erased. Allahu Akbar. Look at how great the rewards are, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Such great rewards Allah the Almighty is waiting to bestow upon us. It is just upon us to make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A very beautiful hadith, the following hadith that I'm going to narrate unto you all, it is recorded in Bukhari and Muslim, and this is the last hadith in the book of Imam Bukhari rahimahullah. A beautiful hadith indeed. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said,
كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان حبيبتان إلى الرحمن سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم.
Two statements, كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that two statements are light on your tongue. خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان. Heavy on your scales. Two statements which are light on your tongue, heavy on your scales. حبيبتان إلى الرحمن. Most beloved unto Ar-Rahman, unto the most merciful, unto Allah. And what are those two statements, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam? Subhanallahi wa bihamdih, subhanallahi al-azim. Subhanallahi wa bihamdih, subhanallahi al-azim. Look at how easy these statements are. Easy upon our tongues, but heavy on the scales, Allahu Akbar. On the scales, when we need these good deeds, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, these adhkar will come to us on the day when we need them the most, Allahu Akbar. Remember, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, the only size of regret of the dwellers of Jannah will be that, oh, I should have said one more subhanallah. We will be in Jannah. We will be in Jannah. But the only size of regret and grief that you and I will have is that we should have said one more subhanallah. We should have said one more alhamdulillah. We should have said one more Allahu Akbar. For each subhanallah, a tree would have been planted in our orchards, Allahu Akbar. In our acres, in our gardens, trees and gardens would have been planted for us, Allahu Akbar. If we had only spent that little time in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And through this remembrance of Allah, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, our hearts that are full of trouble, our hearts that are full of grief at times, our hearts will find rest, our hearts will find peace through the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us excessively remember Allah the Almighty. Let us make excessive dhikr, resulting in us being blessed with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and resulting in our hearts being softened and our hearts turning towards Allah the Almighty and our hearts remembering Allah the Almighty often. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins, and may He the Almighty soften our hearts, and may He fill our hearts with the desire to make more and more dhikr, to make more and more remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and may He the Almighty accept our good deeds. May He help us to end this month of Ramadan attaining the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and may He bless us with the opportunity to attain more and more Ramadan. Allahu Akbar. And may He the Almighty unite us in the gardens of Jannah, just as how He united us here tonight with our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameen wa akhir da'wai anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Jazakumullahu khair.
Donate now. Go to www.thedailyreminder.org/donate. And stay updated by joining our network's social links.